Hi everyone. You, like me, thought we'd seen the last of online church for a while, but here we are again. My name's Donna, and I'll be leading us through this morning's service. And right up front, I'd just like to thank everyone who has very quickly pivoted into constructing this morning's service and rearranged the initial plan that we had to adjust to church being closed this week. We have thoroughly enjoyed and appreciated being together again at TLC, so hopefully this 5-day lockdown will just be a minor hiccup. So welcome to TLC Community Church. Whether you come regularly or are visiting us this morning, it's great to have you with us. For those who were present when I led the service about a month ago in my pajamas, I hope I have dressed more appropriately today. So the Premier's conference has just finished, announcing stage 4 restrictions, the ones that we experienced last year, but just for 5 days. So let's do all we can to ensure that this lockdown does only last 5 days. We've got an important part to play in that. I know we and the rest of the world are very focused on the COVID pandemic. It's consumed our thinking, our news, and it's a frequently changing landscape. But it's important to not lose perspective on other issues that sometimes get pushed to the background when we're distracted by what's in our face. Also in the news this past week, there was mention again of another pandemic that's been around for longer than COVID and that's taken more lives than COVID, and that's racism. Racism is endemic in our society. It's passed on from generation to generation, often unconsciously. It is the antithesis of God's design for the world, of the responsibility God charged human beings with in caring for this planet, of caring for each other as human beings, as equal human beings made in God's image. And it is the opposite of love. So as we explore the theme of God's love today, his enduring love that Mike will later preach about, let us remember that we were created to love each other as God loves us, valuing and respecting each person, no matter their race or culture, their age, gender, ability or difference, socioeconomic position, and so on. Psalm 136 reminds us that God's love endures forever. God's love made the heavens and earth. God's love rescued the Israelites who were enslaved to the Egyptians, also experiencing racism. I think the children in this video clip that we're about to watch actually have grasped what God's love is all about. So sit back and enjoy.
Love is like over a gillion stuff.
Helping someone even if you don't want to.
When your parents or your teachers don't tell you to.
Giving away stuff that you really, really like.
If they want their toys, I'll share.
Sale? Toys?
It's smiling and saying good things about them.
I should say, you have very nice clothes on.
I hope my mommy.
I played with another person on the playground when she didn't have anybody to play with.
And people are loving to me. I feel like I should do it to someone else.
Because Jesus did the same for us.
Just like your daughter says you will have them do to you.
That you should treat the other one just like I've been treated before. Not like bad, but the kind I've been good treated.
Nobody really wants to play with somebody who's being mean.
Being kind is helping those in need.
Give them some food.
Get fish and bread and green beans and peas and apples.
I'll ask my mom and or dad.
Can we go get food for this hungry person that I found?
Love is
hugging your mom and helping her wash the dishes.
I just get the water thing and just spray them.
People show me love by holding my hand. And they also give me a kiss around the head when I'm asleep very lightly.
There's people that don't get love in other places of the world.
You help them.
Just help people.
If we show people love, they can spread it all around the world.
Okay, come here, Mommy. I'll show her something.
you something. Come here, Mommy.
How cute were those kids? I think those children have reminded us what love really is. So this morning and through the week, let's focus on what God is saying to us about love in action. Let me pray as we share time together today. God of wonder, God of love, you have shown us what it means to follow you, to act justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with you. Help us to love by challenging our own thoughts when they don't match yours, to love by acting in the way Jesus would act, to be salt and light in this world, and to be willing to change ourselves to be more like you. And I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. I'll now hand over to the musos who will lead us in song this morning.
1, 2, 3, 4. God and King, His love endures forever. For He is good, He is above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise. With a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, His love endures forever. That's been reborn, His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is faithful, forever God is strong. Setting sun, His love endures forever, and by the grace of God we will carry on. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise, sing.
Let's move into a time of praying for our community and other significant issues. Let's pray. Lord, as Melburnians experience restrictions to their lives, may we be ever more mindful of the many people in the world who face restrictions of a political, economic, safety, physical, mental and health nature every day of their lives. Sustain them, we pray. Thank you for our staff, pastors, elders and volunteers who continue to offer support and care to the TLC community and Bayswater neighbourhood. Bless them, we ask. May we continue to be faithful in our financial support and in helping in practical ways as well, so that we may be salt and light in the community. And God, for all our young people and children, please nurture them, encourage them, develop them to be resilient people who grow to love you. Lord, we want to encourage a dear member as she recovers from surgery following the fall she had last week, which resulted in a broken kneecap. We pray for relief from the pain, for good healing, for excellent medical care, and for no concerns about having the time off from her work. Lord, we pray for others in our community who are managing health issues. One who's experiencing vertigo from Meniere's disease, another with an infected and painful ulcer on her leg. And we're thankful that a dear friend is now home from hospital, recovering from heart surgery. God, we're grateful for the positive news about the unborn baby, whose recent scans show the growth does not appear to be a serious issue now. We continue to pray for that baby and the required surgery when the baby's 6 months old. Be with the parents and supportive grandparents. Help them all to trust you as they progress through these last few months of the pregnancy. Many concerning issues are present in different countries around the world. God, there's still wars in Afghanistan, Yemen, Syria, Mexico, Turkey, Somalia, Eritrea, Ethiopia, Sudan, Iraq, Israel and Palestine. And the coup in Myanmar is also impacting so many innocent people. We pray for a just resolution there with no further loss of lives or disadvantaging of the poor and vulnerable. And Lord, we pray for our own nation, that we could be united rather than divided, that we could respond to the needs around us rather than focusing on ourselves, that we could strive for justice and equality for all, that we could all take responsibility for tackling racism amongst many other social issues that require our response. We pray for Mike as he brings your word to us today. May we integrate your wisdom into our everyday lives. Be with each one of us as we allow your love to transform us so that we can love others in the way you love us. We offer all these prayers and those on our hearts in Jesus' precious name. Amen. So join with the musos now as we sing together. Then Megan's got something for the children and Mike will bring us the message. Following that, we'll enjoy communion together.
My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you. All of my days I want to praise the wonders of your mighty love. My comfort, my shelter, tower of refuge and strength, let every breath, all that I am, never cease to worship you. Shout to the Lord, all the earth, let us sing. Power and majesty, praise to the King. Mountains bow down
Hey kids, how's it going? Well, this isn't how we thought we'd be doing church this week, but here we are again. And however you're feeling about that, whether you're happy to be stuck inside all weekend, doing whatever you like to do, or whether you're feeling a little bit sad or anxious about it, that's okay. But it's important to remember to still try and be thankful for things amongst every circumstance. Today we're going to read a short little story called Count My Blessings. Thank you, Lord, for the food I eat, for carrots and apples that are crisp and sweet. I give thanks as I get dressed and choose which sweater would be best. I thank you for cats and rabbits too, for dogs and lambs and cows that moo. Thank you for friends who come to play, for the fun that we have day to day. I thank you for all the love we share as I count my blessings and say my prayers. Well, hopefully we'll see each other next week, but until then, stay safe and enjoy the rest of the weekend.
Steve. Good morning and welcome to Truth and Liberation Concern. This is a Sunday morning. Normally we would be all gathered around together, but because of COVID we're actually find ourselves once more going back to a podcast and having to record the services and send it out to you in a podcast. And so this morning we're actually beginning our series on wonder. Wonder, that amazing sort of word that we actually don't use a lot these days, partly because I think we're a little bit jaded. We're actually faced with the fact that we see so many things, hear so many things. Digital TV, television and film is such that it can actually create almost any kind of wonder with the old green screen and backdrop. So for most of us, it's like, yeah, been there, done that, got the t-shirt, read the book, seen the film. So we're actually somewhat sort of jaded. However, we felt that it would be useful to for us as an organisation and as a congregation, as a group and a people, that we would actually spend a bit of time looking at the notion of wonder and how it relates to God. Now, I sat down with the word wonder and I thought, okay, what if I was to expand that so I would remember the word wonder? And so for myself, I wrote wakefully ordained nuance, delightfully encouraging respect. I'll read that again. Wakefully ordained nuance, delightfully encouraging respect. That might be something that you might sort of think about doing in the weeks to come as we go through our series, to reflect on the word wonder and to reflect on what it actually means for you, and then actually see if you can actually take the letters of the word wonder and actually build together a set of phrases. See what you come up with and send it into us. The next slide that's going to appear on the screen is a picture of Snoopy and Charlie Brown staring at the stars. And Charlie Brown says, wonder and awe almost mean the same thing, Snoopy. But wonderful and awful are opposites. Snoopy replies, that's awesome. When we come to today's passage, we're looking at Psalm 136. This is an amazing psalm, and it's a psalm about praise. It's a psalm that lists off all the things that God wonderfully has done, and the people respond with a sense of his love endures forever. And it's a repeat phrase that gets used throughout the entire psalm of praise. Now, there are numerous psalms of praise in the Old Testament, and we're actually reflecting particularly on this Psalm 136, which is known as the Hallel. However, if you were to look at Psalm 113 through to 118, you'll actually discover these are the Egyptian Hallel, and these were actually read on Passover Day. Whereas if you were to look at Psalms 120 to 136, they're often referred to as the Great Hallel. In our Talmudic discussion of liturgical use of Psalms 113 to 118, they focus on how the psalm incorporates gratitude for God's past acts of salvation and confidence in God's future redemption. In other words, it looks at the Exodus from Egypt, the splitting of the Red Sea, the giving of the Torah, the revival of the dead, and the difficulties preceding for them, the Messianic age. In other words, Hallel dealt with all of Jewish history, from the birth of their nation to the establishment of the Messianic era. In Hallel, it expresses joy at past miracles and faith in future miracles. So when we come to read Psalm 136, we recognise that it's a fairly lengthy psalm, but it's one in which the passages, first of all, talk about how God is good and he is God over all things. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Give thanks to the God of gods. His love endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord of Lords. His love endures forever. To him who alone does great wonders, his love endures forever. Then it goes on to talk about his creation and why he made creation. Who by his understanding made the heavens, his love endures forever. Who spread out the earth upon the waters, his love endures forever. Who made the great lights, his love endures forever. The sun to govern the day, his love endures forever. The moon and stars to govern the night, his love endures forever. Then reflects on, the next part of the psalm reflects on what God's actions were as God helped out his people. To him who struck down the firstborn of Egypt, his love endures forever, and brought out of Israel, out from among them, his love endures forever. With a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, his love endures forever. To him who divided the Red Sea asunder, his love endures forever, and brought Israel through the midst of it, his love endures forever. But swept Pharaoh and his armies into the Red Sea, his love endures forever. To him who led his people through the wilderness, his love endures forever. And then it moves on to when they came out of the wilderness to how God defeated Israel's enemies. His love endures forever, and he killed mighty kings. His love endures forever. Sihon, king of the Amorites, his love endures forever. And Og, king of Bashan, his love endures forever. And gave the land as an inheritance. His love endures forever. An inheritance to his servant Israel. And then a reminder that God is always with us. He remembered us in our low estate. His love endures forever. And freed us from our enemies. His love endures forever. And he gives food to every creature. His love endures forever. Give thanks to the God of heaven. So this psalm is a psalm of praise of all the great work that God has done. But it's also a psalm that encompasses the amazing covenant relationship that we have with our God. Because the word love is actually the Hebrew word chesed. It's pronounced chesed. It's spelt C-H-E-S-E-D, but it's spelt with a kr at the front. So when you see it, when you're pronouncing it, then that's how you say it. It's chesed means loving kindness, steadfast love, grace, mercy, faithfulness, goodness, devotion. This word is used 240 times in the Old Testament, and it's especially frequent in the Psalms. The term is one of the most important in the vocabulary of Old Testament theology and ethics. The Septuagint nearly always renders chesed with eleos, meaning mercy. And that usage is reflected in the New Testament. In general, one may identify three basic meanings of the word, which always interact: strength, steadfastness, and love. Any understanding of the word that fails to suggest all three inevitably loses some of its richness. Love by itself just becomes sentimental. Strength, steadfastness, on the other hand, suggests the fulfillment of a legal or other obligation. However, together, they combine to make a sense of wholeness, oneness, completeness. Love that's made out of compassion, love that's given in mercy, one that's steadfast and strong. The word refers primarily to mutual and reciprocal rights and obligations between the parties of a relationship. In this case, Yahweh and Israel. But chesed is not only a matter of obligation, it's also of generosity. It's not only a matter of loyalty, but also of mercy. The weaker party seeks the protection and blessing of the patron and protector, but he may not lay absolute claim to it. The stronger party remains committed to his promise, but retains his freedom, especially in regards to the manner in which he will implement those promises. So, Cressid implies a personal involvement and a commitment in a relationship beyond the rule of law. Biblical use of the word frequently speaks of someone doing, showing, or keeping Cressid. It's a concrete word. God's mercies, God's kindness, God's faithfulnesses. Behind all these uses, God is all-powerful. He is the one who is extending the loving kindness. He is the one who is offered to his people who need redemption from sin, who need redemption from their enemies, who need redemption from the troubles. So therefore, God is the one permanent element in the flux of covenantal history. Because essentially, that covenant is something that we buy into, courtesy of Jesus. It's a covenant that we have with God. And so, like the Israeli people, like the Jewish people, we can actually say with them, his mercy, his loving mercy, his steadfast love endures forever. Such is the relationship that we have with a powerful God. What amazingly wondrous thing that is for us, because it means that God is with us. God is for us. Sometimes we have this doubt that we go through in our mind. We wonder, are we saved? Does God really care? Is God going to be there for us in the end? This psalm reminds us that God's steadfast love endures forever. The word Cressid teaches us that God's love is a deep love. It's a profound love. It's a perfect love. It is one that will always, always seek us out. And so this day, as we briefly reflect on this psalm, let us take time to actually recognize that we are God's people who are deeply loved. This is just a shortened version of the message because it's very hard to record a lengthy message and engage well with people. So I apologize for its shortness, but we'll just keep it simple for today. Let me pray. Father God, who is good to us, we thank you for your grace. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your power. But more than all of this, we thank you of your steadfast love born out for us through Christ, through that covenant relationship that we have with you. That means that we and Christ are one and part of your created family. We give you thanks this day and praise you for all things. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.
O sovereign God, O matchless King, the saints adore, the angels sing, and fall before the throne of grace. To you belongs the highest praise. This suffering's this passing tide, under every enemy will flee. You are my hope.
Hopefully next week we'll be back at TLC, so keep your eye out for emails from the TLC office. And if you need support, don't hesitate to contact the office, please. Look out for each other, check on each other. I'd like to finish now by reading from Isaiah chapter 54, verse 10. For the mountains may depart and the hills be removed, but my steadfast love shall not depart from you, and my covenant of peace shall not be removed, says the Lord, who has compassion on you. So go into this week holding tightly onto that promise from God, actively loving others. Bless you.